Okay.
Say hello to George, George Beck, and a mix with the freshmen. Ladies and gentlemen, at the piano, Mr. John Hasselback and the George Beck Orchestra.
Good evening. It's so nice to have you with us. And it's not a great day for golf, so you've made the right choice. You're with us again this evening. I just had one announcement I want to make. Tonight's lotto drawing will be worth $35 million. You know, guys, we made the right choice here. We got these guys in the lead. We're going to have a good time. Starting off with the soloists. That was Rube's Blues, by the way, a theme song that our dear friend George Beck always used on his radio shows. Sam Felzone, say hello to him on tenor sax. And on the trombone, the first trombone soloist is John Hasselback Jr. And my good friend from South Wales, New York, this is the baritone saxophonist, a long time with George's orchestra. This is James Tudini. So and our next trombone soloist was Phil Simmons. Phil Simmons. And our lead alto player, say hello to Dave Chabon. Dave Chabon. As the night goes on, I'll introduce the rest of the guys, and we have some really interesting music, and it's a real treat for us to be here tonight. We'd like to continue on with another great Stan Kenton chart. This one arranged and written by Bill Holman, who was still a very tremendous force in modern big band arranging and writing. This is the Benny Goodman favorite, Stompin' at the Savoy.
Thank you.
Okay, great chart. Bill Holman, just a phenomenal writer. We love everything he does. And you'll hear some more of Bill's later in the evening. Alto saxophone solo, and that say hello to Richard Griffo, Dick Griffo. And our trumpet soloist this evening, Sam Noto. Sam Noto. Okay, Stan Kenton, you know, he just had a great band over many, many years, and not only was it a great jazz band, but I think he had a very good and very slick commercial side to the things that he did. And this band of his had a great sound with a trombone section and always had a great trombone choir sound. And some of the things that were perhaps less bebop oriented were those sounds that you would find in a romantic setting. And maybe some of you gentlemen and ladies remember a time when this was a song you might have heard while you were spending some time with a favorite friend. Okay. And this features our trombone section, and I think that you'll enjoy this and you'll agree with me that it's a great tune. This is a Lenny Niehaus arrangement from an album that Stan had done. It's called The Stage Door Swings, and this is from Guys and Dolls, I've Never Been in Love Before.
Thank you.
Since we had them up, I think I'll introduce the gentleman in the trombone section. You met the two guys on the end, Phil Sims, of course, here, and John Hasselback, Jr., and Angelo Calea. And bass trombone, you notice that this has a lot more plumbing. He spends more time in the hardware store than the rest of us. This is Fred Secor. Okay, this next chart before we play it, I hope you don't mind my rambling on a little bit here. I'd like to share some of the things with you that I think go beyond the music a bit. We know we're here to hear the Four Freshmen here tonight, and we know that we're playing and featuring a lot of music of Stan Kenton, and that was something that George Beck was a very big proponent of. Many of us have shared some time on the road playing in some wonderful bands. We have a gentleman in this band, though, that I really would like to recognize. 1953, and all the way to 1960, he was on the road, and he was with Stan Kenton. Played trumpet with Stan's band. Just earlier, he told me a story about how he got on the band. It was very interesting. He was replacing, the bus had an accident in 1953, and some of the trumpet players actually banged their lip on the seat in front of them, and so Stan was in a real pickle, and he was coming through Buffalo, and Sam got the call, and stayed on the band from 1953 to 1960. We'd like to feature Sam playing an Angelo Calea arrangement tonight. This is entitled Cherokee. And we're going to have Sam, if you will, can you come down this down here? Okay. And won't you please welcome, this is one of the original guys, one of the innovators that really put Stan and the whole band where it is today in our hearts. Won't you welcome Sam Noah when we play Sherry.
Thank you.
by the great Stan Kenton. Stan Kenton. That's just a treasure right here in Western New York, you know, and that's just the way it is. That's the way we feel about Sam up here in this band. Ange Kalea, a great arranger, and Ange, won't you take a bow for that wonderful arrangement, I'm sure. Okay, we're going to go back to a Bill Holman arrangement. This is, I think this is from a movie, maybe One Touch of Venus, and this is entitled Speak Low, Speak Low. This will feature, by the way, Sam Felzon on tenor saxophone. Well, we have a little twist here for you. I guess you are here to hear the Four Freshmen and to hear the George Beck Orchestra. And never guess that this next introduction is going to take you back a little bit. I don't mean to make it like Twilight Zone, but please, Tom Burke, if you're ready in a moment here, you listen to the house speakers here. And I'm going to let a special guy introduce the Four Freshmen. Ladies and gentlemen, Stan Kenton.
I know that those of you who witnessed the performance of the next four gentlemen before, nothing need be said. You're anxiously awaiting your appearance here. For those of you that haven't seen them before, I might add you're in for a great and continuous thrill. And nothing makes these fellows perform like a lot of applause when they hit the stage. So let's let them hear it. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, the Four Freshmen.
Shadows from above, boy, see, yeah.
to you all. Before we go any further, how about another for wonderful hand for the George Beck Orchestra, led by George Hasselback. And by before we go too much further, it might be wise to introduce the guys in the group. Bob, that's Brian right there.
Bob, great. We're so sorry.
That's an old joke, but we're an old group, so it kind of fits, you know what I mean? Anyway, seriously, on my left here with the fantastic trombone, and when we work self-contained, which we'll be doing in the second half of the show, he plays guitar and bass, sings the third part of the vocal harmonies, is originally from Salt Lake City. This is Kevin Stout, the doctor. On my right here, singing the fourth part in the harmonies, he's got a great solo voice that we'll be featuring very shortly too. And when we work self-contained, he plays drums, and he's from Seattle, Washington. This is Bob Ferreira. The only remaining original member. You think they believe you, Brian? No, we grabbed Brian right out of college. He's a very talented young man. He's made a big difference in our sound already. Sings the second part of the vocal harmonies, and when we work self-contained, he plays bass and drums. Sings the second part. This is, well, he's from Apple Valley, Minnesota, I should mention. This is Brian Eichenberg.
Trumpet, and when we work with self-contained, he plays keyboards and flugelhorn as well. He sings the lead part in the vocal harmonies, and he's from Carmel, California. This is Greg Steckman.
Thank you very much. Well, most of you might remember Poinciana, the second tune we did there. That was one of the very first arrangements that the group put together. They couldn't afford arrangers when they were literally four freshmen in college. And that was done in, believe it or not, 1949 for the first time. We'd like to make a quantum leap forward and let you know the freshmen are alive and well in 1997 and do something that we're gonna be recording for our next album. It's a great old standard from Mr. Cole Porter. This is Get Out of Town. very much. A long-standing tradition with the freshmen is to feature at least one of the guys in the group on a solo, and we're no exception. We've got an outstanding soloist here in Bob. This is a beautiful song written by Jack Siegel, the guy who penned When Sunny Gets Blue. We feel this is destined to be a new standard. It's a very pretty thing. A song about regret. It's simply titled More Love. On the stage tonight. Normally we hate to, but yeah, that was sweet, Bob. Yeah, we feel that's going to be a new standard. We're going to close our portion of the show just this half with a famous thing we hope you all recognize. In fact, we want to dedicate it to a special couple here tonight, Bob and Alice McGuire. Are you here this evening, the McGuires? Make yourselves known, folks, if you're here. Bob? It was going to be a special evening, right? Oh, yeah. another gentleman who was kind enough to have us on his radio show, his jazz show at the local station.
Oh, they're here?
Oh, they are here. Okay,
okay, never mind.
Yeah, don't be
sorry,
guys. And then again, to you now. Apparently, this next tune is a special. They have a 78 recording of this thing. You guys remember 78s, right?
Yeah.
78 years old, man.
No, I don't mean the year 78. I'm talking about, you know, the discs, 78s, you know, before even 33 and a thirds.
Yeah, I remember 78.
Forget about it. Anyway, we've got a lot more music coming up in the second
Make
it
gun, 33 and a third. Remember that?
Yeah, okay. Anyway, we did an interview with a gentleman by the name of Macy Faber that you probably are familiar with at WBFO, right?
Yeah.
And, I don't know if Macy's here this evening, but we'd like to dedicate this to him as well. This is a tune that really helped put this group on the map. You might remember Day by Day.
Thank you.
Ever since 1948, when the group started out, we've augmented slightly, but basically, this is what the freshmen have always done, accompanying themselves, and that's what's kept us in the business this long, and what really set us apart from all other vocal groups. But we're going to do a brand new thing for you that we're going to put on our new album, this time arranged by young Brian over there. We're a big fan of Johnny Mandel, one of our best composer arrangers, and this is Close Enough for Love.
Close enough for love.
Hasselback and George Beck Orchestra here, these great musicians. There's an album the group recorded on Capitol Records in about 1962, which was very significant in the history of the group. It was called The Swingers, and it was arranged by a gentleman that you've heard many arrangements from already this evening, Mr. Bill Holman, who's still very active. In fact, he won a Grammy last year for Best Big Band Arrangement. He wrote this entire album for the Freshmen, and the original album featured some of the best jazz players in Hollywood at the time, like Frank Rossellino, Beck, Kenton, musicians, Connie Condoli, Mel Lewis was on drums, Jimmy Rolls on piano, no talents like that. And we'd like to do a tune from that album for you right now. This is one of our favorite arrangements. This is Steve Allen's great tune. This could be the start of something big.
farewell party, or else you'll know that man is suddenly dead.
You're looking at someone's eyes, you suddenly realize that this could be the start of something big.
You mention it 21 and watched you die. Before I need a shot, it reaches something I'll take.
When I look in the sky, you suddenly melancholy, and this could be the start of something big. There's no controlling me, I'm only love you think, my friend. Who knows the drift in the magic book? But when a loving discovered and the game, my friend, invited in without a second look.
You're up in an aeroplane, or dining at Sardi's, or lying in a thousand room alone in the sand.
You suddenly do the bell, and right away you can tell. Could be the start of something grand. You're doing your intel tax, or buying a new patch, or hurry your home, you got the hours late. There you go, the next day you go, and this could be the start of something grand.
Your destined lover you'll discover in a frightening flash, so keep your heart awake both night and day.
Because
thank you.
close out our portion of the self-contained show before we bring out the George Beck Band one more time with another brand new arrangement we hope to put on the new album. It's another classic from Nat King Cole. Do you want to say anything about this?
No.
Okay. This is this is he does this to me every night. This is something that actually written by Nat. A lot of people don't know he wrote some tunes himself, and I think this is one of the earliest things he ever did, but Kevin put a new twist on it. I think you might recognize Straighten Up and Fly Right. Educator for years, and then a principal, Bunch Tech, Lafayette, sorry. Say hello to Sam Scamonca. And in the trumpet section, of course, we heard the great Sam Dono, and to his immediate right, we have our lead trumpet player, who's just returned from playing with Doc Severinsen. He He spent many years on the Tommy Dorsey Band with Buddy Morrow, the great lead trumpet player here, Dennis Trabuzzi. And a very unique situation, you know, you realize it's a father and son situation with the pianist myself and my son John playing trombone. The next two gentlemen sitting next to each other also happen to be father and son. I think you'll see that this is, we call this fellow Dick Reeder. Stand up, Dick. And if you've seen him around, you'll see him playing piano, you see him playing drums, he plays marvelous trumpet. This guy is just unbelievable, Dick Reeder. And his son, who you might see once in a while if you get to the BPO, that's the Buffalo Philharmonic, this is, we call him Rich Reeder. Okay? And in the rhythm section, this is really a special treat for me to work with these two gentlemen. Every chance I get to play with them, I always call them. And on bass, been around the world, cruise ships. He's played with the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra. He plays in the Buffalo Philharmonic. He does just about everything. You see him in the barroom buzzards. This guy plays tuba, he plays bass, electric bass, phenomenal. Paul Zampalowski. Now, the whole ticker in the rhythm section is this special guy that sits right behind me, our timekeeper extraordinaire. He's been, you'll see him playing in a lot of different bands because he's so sought after, he's so special. And won't you please say hello to Louis Marino on drums. Okay, and no more chatter here. We're going to get started with one more of the great Kenton favorites. This is Dynaflow.
Thank you.
arrangement, I Remember You, featuring Dave Chabon on alto saxophone and Sam Noah again on trumpet. Now I come to a portion of the show here. This, of course, is the George Beck Orchestra. And you may know that George, we lost him a year ago in March, very suddenly, unexpectedly. And all this week I thought so much about him as we were preparing to come to the theater and do our performance. And what I think of George is as a messenger, okay? And in radio, in music, in all of his life and all that he did, a messenger. And he loved the music, he loved the music. I'd say he loved the music like he loved golf. And we remember him with his great golf stories. And all of us knew George as George Beck. And at the funeral service, we heard many of his dear friends and relatives speak at the service. And they were referring to this man as Buddy, And many of us didn't know him as Buddy. And so this was a new experience for me. And so we had a great arranger in our band here. And his name is Ange Kalea. I think you've met Ange. And he came up with this arrangement. And we'd like to dedicate this to George and to his memory. As the messenger who was called home, but he's always with us. And he's kept this music alive. And we're really very thankful over the years. In the last, say, 10 or 12 years, we've had the freshmen here. We've had Kenton alumni here to play with. We've had Maynard Ferguson and many great talents, I am sure. And all of these things were the undertaking of George Beck. Great man in his ability to organize, also to play. A risk taker at times, because this can be quite an extensive operation, as you might imagine. So this is our tribute to George, and we all know him now as Buddy. This is My Buddy.
Thank you.
That's Sam Shalaya, great arranging, my buddy. Back to the great ballad style of Stan Kenton, if you will, with the trombones. And very often the band would go out, it would be sometimes 10 brass. Here you see we have an 8 brass band. And I see the freshmen, they didn't say goodnight, did they? There's a trombone there. There's four over there. We've got a fifth part here, don't we? You got a stand and a light there. Kevin, is he... He's in the back there, so if you give him a hand, maybe we'll get him to come out and do you get extra for this, Mr. Staff?
That's great.
He's such a good-natured guy. Okay. This is a tune entitled, But Beautiful, and again, trombones. Can we get you to stand up here, guys, and serenade us with this great trombone ballad, But Beautiful.
Thank you.
You know, before I this will be my probably my last opportunity to talk, and I should shut up, but I have to say a few things. I want to thank Dick Baldwin. He's connected here with the university. He and the kids from Habitat, Chuck Drumstead, okay, and the kids from the Habitat chapter here at the university, you should really be proud of these folks. These young adults are really leading the way, and we could really put our hands together and give these young folks a real good week. They really helped make this this whole operation come off as smoothly as it has, and I really thank them. And you know, Kevin's still here, and I bet you think maybe the guys are still back in the wings here listening to what he's saying. Ladies and gentlemen, the Four Freshmen.
Thank you.
We'd like to do another freshman favorite for you, this time from an album called Freshman Year. It celebrated the 10-year anniversary of the group on the Capitol Records label. The group recorded about 25 albums on that label at the same time that Frank Sinatra, Nat King Cole, George Shearing were recording on the label, and that's pretty good company. So we'd like to do something from the Freshman Year album. This is a beautiful standard called Fools Rush In. Associated with Nat King Cole. It was written by Mr. Bobby Troup, also one of the earliest things that Nat did, and it's been recorded by close to 100 artists over the years, including the Four Freshmen, and we'd like to do it once again with the great George Beck Band, and I think you know why we feature Kevin quite a bit here on the horn solo, so he's going to take a spot here in the middle of this thing. We'd like to invite you on one more trip down Route 66.
Go. Find the Arizona, don't forget Winona. Keep the bus, don't stop.
Stan Kenton.
It's a blue world. Thank you, everyone. Thank you again.